Hollywood to home soil right here in Australia, the Me Too movement has women across the globe sharing their stories of sexual harassment and assault in their various industries. And while the casting couch is rife in the world of actresses and models, you'd think the tech world might be a little bit exempt. Well, the female CEO of a zero-waste solutions business, The Clean Collective, found that Silicon Valley offered more than just skin in the game for technology. Charlie Thompson joins us this morning to share her incredible story. Hello, Charlie, welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Now, you were actually invited to Silicon Valley to seek investment, but you felt a little bit out of your depth at the time. Can you take us through what actually happened?
Yeah, so I was invited over to a specific event for businesses that are focused on creating social or environmental impact to meet investors over there.
Mm-hmm. So a big deal.
Big deal. And it was really exciting because it felt like it was going to be this really great fit for the business. It's hard to find the right investor. You know, it's like this constant match game. So we had gone over there really excited about it. But by day two, I'd got this feeling that I wasn't quite in the right place, that it was a lot techier than the business I work for. And I, by the end of the day, this angel sort of came up to me and he said, how are you finding it? And I had this sort of overwhelm of honesty, and I said to him, you know, I actually don't think I'm in the right place. I'm not building flying cars, which someone actually was doing.
Wow.
I said, I'm just using technology to try and empower people to tackle climate change and take control of their health. And he said, I'm interested in climate change investments. And so this conversation ensues, a very big conversation about The Clean Collective, what it's doing, and the latest climate science.
So you promised, you booked a promising lunch, it all looked great.
Mm.
Then what happened?
So we book a lunch, we go and we continue the next day the discussion, and investors want to get to know the founders. They want to know that you're not going to give up,
yeah,
that you're in it, you know, through the tough times. That's it. And so we're having a chat and he's asking a few questions and I'm answering, and he introduces his hobby, which is photography. He's already got the portfolio out on his phone, and he says to me that he would like to capture me. And as he says that, he shows me some of the images that he's taken.
What were they like?
They were interesting. They were cropped in a way where you're left wondering whether the women are wearing clothes.
Oh, nice.
But what he didn't realise is that as he's turning the ones that he'd like me not to see away, they're being reflected in his wine glass, revealing a little bit more skin.
Oh, golly.
Oh, mm.
That is just so old-fashioned.
Mm.
Oh, other than the iPhone. any indication that if you'd let him photograph you? Because he talked about why women wanted to be photographed. Let me in on that.
Yeah, the intention or the insinuation was definitely that there was an investment for the business,
uh-huh,
if there was a photograph.
But also about women CEOs. Why do women CEOs want to be photographed?
Right, exactly. So when I asked for his clarify your intentions to me, one of the things that he said to me was that my dismissive reaction was unusual because most women become CEOs because they want fame.
Wow.
Mm.
How old was this guy?
I'd say mid-50s.
And what was your reaction? What did you do?
I was shocked. I was really shocked because the conversation had been so professional up until that point.
What did you say?
I asked him for clarification. I've thought at the first I was like, am I misunderstanding this? Mm. And he said that at that point he confessed that he had picked me out of the crowd at the conference, that he wanted to photograph me despite the level of business discussion he'd engaged me with, that he'd booked the restaurant two blocks away from his photography studio, and if I went there, he couldn't be sure what would happen.
Ah!
Oh, lovely. Mm.
You say he was very, very well rehearsed. He'd obviously pitched this idea to many women and had the photo evidence to prove it.
Yes.
What would you say to other women in all industries who might come up against something like this? How do you extract yourself from a possibly dangerous situation like you found yourself in?
Yeah, I think the reason I felt so compelled to speak out about it was to let other founders know that this happens, to be prepared so that they can be ready to get up and walk away from that table as quickly as possible.
Mm-hmm.
I think realising, oh, we're in that Silicon Valley story.
Mm.
And the more we speak up about it, the less these people will be able to get away with it.
Well, thankfully, your business is thriving at the moment, the Clean Collective. Charlie, thank you so much for joining us
today. Thank you.
Well done. Well spoken out.
Really good advice.